Welcome to WCTM Breaking News, by kids, for kids. My name is Emmett Fay-Leblanc, and I'm here today with Troy Bennett and Dean Cleag from the Half Moon Joke Band. Thank you so much for being with us today.
Well, thanks for having us. We appreciate you asking questions.
Thanks, Emmett.
Will you guys just tell us a little bit about your band? Does your songwriting process look like?
Yeah, no problem. We're in the Half Moon Joke Band, and the Half Moon Jug Band has been around for about 22 years, something like that. Started back in the 1990s, and being a jug band just means that we're kind of we're like what we call homemade music, meaning that we play guitars and banjos, and Dean plays the drums, and there's a saxophone, and there's a bass, and there's some kazoo, and anything else we could think of. It's all stuff thrown together like in a big dish and mixed up. And from the beginning of the band, way back then, we were always writing our own music because there wasn't any music that seemed to fit us exactly. So we had to write our own. And we immediately started writing things about our lives here in Maine, about Maine things, about tuna fish casserole and other fun stuff. We mostly do funny songs, except for the one you're going to ask us about is not funny. It's a little bit of a change for us. But in terms of songwriting, I write most of the songs. And my only secret is the chorus always comes first, you know, the part that repeats. And it's got to be really memorable and really catchy. And the way I know it's catchy is if I can write it in my head while I'm doing something else, like walking or cooking or something. And if I can still remember it an hour later, that means it's pretty good.
Stand firm, you boys from Maine. For not once in a century are men permitted to bear such responsibility for freedom and justice, for God and humanity, as are now placed upon you.
What inspired you to write a song about Joshua Chamberlain?
It was Dean Cleag who inspired me to write a song about wherever Dean in this pyramid here. And I thought, I knew who Joshua Chamberlain was, and I thought, that's interesting. What was much more interesting was Dean's enthusiasm for the story of Joshua Chamberlain's life and how much time he put into learning about it, and his excitement over always telling the story of Joshua Chamberlain to people made me excited to then tell it to some people.
Can you tell us a little bit about Joshua Chamberlain's connection to Maine and the Civil War?
Sure. Well, Joshua Chamberlain was born here in 1828, so that's 8 years after Maine became a state. He was born up in Brewer near Bangor, and he didn't join the army right when the war broke out in 61. But he saw a lot of the younger men, like I mentioned, go off to war. And that's what led him ultimately to offer his services to the state as a leader of those young men. As he was a teacher at Bowdoin College, he was a bit of a mentor. He got along very well with his students. He was highly regarded by them. And he felt that they needed someone like him to lead them into battle, you know, when it came.
What are other ways to learn about Joshua Chamberlain?
There's lots of books written on him. I brought a couple of examples. For younger readers, this is a book by Diana Halderman Losky. It's a pretty quick, simple read that kind of gives you the details on his family here in Maine through the Civil War. If you want something, this is one of the first books I read. It's a collection of stories, and it's written by John Pullen. And John Pullen was the man who wrote the official biography on the 20th Maine, which was Chamberlain's regiment in the beginning of the war. And John Pullen took a collection of stories about Chamberlain and put them in that book. So there's lots of literature, biographies on Chamberlain. So,
Who's that behind your shoulder, Dean?
There he is, Chamberlain right there.
How did you get involved with the Joshua Chamberlain Museum in Brunswick?
Well, I had gone to the Joshua Chamberlain Museum several years before I started volunteering there. I wanted to go to the museum and a second time, and they were closed. This was around 2011. And they were closed, and I looked them up online for some reason, and I found out that they were looking for volunteer guides. So I called, I said, I'm really interested in this. If you're looking for volunteer guides, I'm not like a scholar or anything. And they said, oh, that's fine. If you have an interest and you want to help, come on up and we'll train you. So it just started by asking. And it turned out to be one of the best chapters, you know, of my life. It didn't pay me anything, but I loved it so much because I got to share a lot of what I was reading and learning about Chamberlain with others. And I was getting to learn from others coming through the museum about tidbits here and there that they knew. A lot of the people that come to the museum, well, not a lot, but some of the people that come to the museum have some kind of a connection, a family connection that they want to share with us. You know, someone that was a relative that was in the 20th Maine or something like that. So that's really cool. You know, it just leads to other things. One thing leads to another, and it's been nothing but a great experience for me. It even led to a really big motorcycle trip that I took down into Virginia. As I was learning more about the 20th Maine and where they were going, I kind of wanted to follow in their footsteps and go visit the battles that they were engaged in. And long story short, it brought me to Appomattox, which is where the Civil War ended. And one of the big things that Chamberlain was really known for is his command of Union troops at Appomattox. He was in full command of every soldier in blue on that day when the Confederates laid their arms down.
Are there any other Maine people that are kind of notable that you would be interested in writing music about?
Oh, for sure. Yeah. There's a ton of people. I've been writing songs long enough to be bored with writing songs about myself, like what I feel or what I think. So it's really fun to think about somebody else's story besides my own. And I have a little list going. One of them is a fellow named Bill Dunlop, who was a man that Dean and I remember from when we were kids. He set some world records for sailing very small boats across oceans. So he sailed a 6-foot boat, which is about as tall as I am. That was the whole length of the boat. He sailed it all the way to England. And then he was trying to sail it around the world, and he got about halfway when he disappeared in 1986, I think. He's sort of been forgotten a little bit. He was a big hero of ours back then, and I think he needs a song, Bill Dunlop. And another person I want to write a song about, which I've never figured out what the chorus might be, is Andre the Seal, who's not really a person. He was a seal, but he was a seal that lived in Rockport when we were kids. And he was a friendly seal, and he had, I guess he had sort of an owner, a guy named Harry Goodrich, who took care of him. But he lived in the harbor, and he did tricks for tourists. And he would spend every winter in an aquarium down in Connecticut. And in the spring, they would let Andre out of the aquarium, just put him in the ocean, and he would swim all the way back to Rockport. And it would be big news. It's like, have we seen Andre? They're letting him go today. How long will it take Andre to get back to Maine? So, Andre the Seal needs a song as well. You can think of anybody, Dean? Who else needs a song?
You stole it right out of my mouth, Bill Dunlop. I was going to say Bill Dunlop.
Where can people listen to your existing music?
Oh, you can, we're not playing any shows right now because of the pandemic, which is a bummer. But you can find all our recorded music on Spotify and on Apple Music. And you can buy CDs if anybody still wants a CD from our website, halfmoonjugband.com. And we've got videos on YouTube.
I think that's all the questions we have.
All right.
Well, thanks for what you're doing and taking a little interest in Chamberlain. I mean, these days, a lot of people take a lot of interest in him, but it's a tough world we're living in right now, especially for young people like you. And knowing the history and kind of what we've already been through, I think it's really important and appropriate to be talking about him these days. So thanks for what you're doing.
Thank you so much, Troy and Dean, for joining us today. This is Emmett with WCTM Breaking News, by kids, for kids.